失控的审判嘛。整个故事它是一个真实的故事哈，那它是改编自《纽约时报》它畅销回忆录《我在关塔纳摩的日子》这本书所改编而成的。那将这个程序正义呢这个题材搬上了大荧幕哈。故事描述的是什么呢？在德国工作的穆罕默杜·萨拉西哈，他因为这个被怀疑跟盖达组织有关联哇，所以说遭到了拘捕，遭到了审问。以及释放啊，但是在2001年呢，他某一天出门之后呢，他就再也没有回到家里面去了。那经过不断的移送呢，在没有审判跟起诉的这个程序之下呢，穆罕默杜呢被送到了美军的关塔纳摩湾的军事监狱去了啊，而且饱受了各种的折磨。那就在他万念俱灰的状况之下呢，这时候出现了一位人权律师，他叫做南希·霍兰德，以及跟他的助手叫做特里·邓肯哈，成了他的盟友了，一起大家来追求所谓的司法正义啊。那整个过程他们也碰到了重重的阻碍，为什么呢？因为他们的提倡也充满了令人争议的这样子的一个状况哈。那这个虽然是这样子，他们在努力哈，那再加上了这个美军检察官斯图亚特库奇中校呢发现的这个证据呢，这样子大家在最后呢反而揭露出了一个令人震撼又庞大的一个阴谋啊，这是整个电影的一个故事了。那朱迪·福斯特呢所饰演的这个人权律师呢，他里面的精湛的演出哈，让他也得了再添了一座金球奖的最佳女配角的奖项哈。那这是朱迪·福斯特呢在金球奖8度提名，并且获得3度的得奖哈。那同时影后朱迪·福斯特呢在奥斯卡也有4度的提名，2度丰厚的这样子的一个光荣的记录哈。那同时这部电影的导演呢，他是由奥斯卡最佳纪录长片《九月的某一天》的导演叫做凯文·麦克唐纳，他所执导的。那联手了班尼迪克·康伯拜区哈，就是大家所熟知的奇异博士了啊，担任这个监制而且参与的演出啊。那班尼迪克他在回忆当初在英国看到了这个参加了这个新书发表会的时候啊，我在关塔纳摩的日子的新书发表会的时候呢，他就觉得太惊艳了哈，这个故事真的太令人惊艳了，他一定要把它拍成电影哈，所以说呢，他也亲自的参与演出了。除了朱迪·福斯特跟那个奇异博士班尼迪克·康伯拜区他们所主演之外呢，这个主要的男主角呢，就是由凯撒奖的影帝塔哈拉辛他所担任的哈。在整个电影当中呢，他诠释了一个无辜被受到指控的恐怖分子。充分的诠释他所产生的这个未知的恐惧哈，而且诠释的非常细腻动人哈，真实的呈现出这个愤怒害怕的情绪以及坚毅不饶的人性啊。我们一起来看看这部电影，叫做《失控的审判》。
If you stray outside the designated areas, you will be removed from the island. It's recommended you wear a hijab when visiting your client. We've had incidents of inmates spitting at female lawyers.
You want to represent the head recruiter for 9/11?
Mohamedou Oudslahi, the Mauritanian held in Guantanamo. He recruited the guys who flew your friend's plane into the South Tower.
He put those men on my husband's plane?
I'm going to make him pay.
In the event the detainee lunges for you, push back away from the table. We'll get in there as quick as we can.
Nancy Hollander, this is my associate. We wish to represent you.
We are seeking the death penalty, but if we miss something, this guy goes home. Let's get to it.
Call this number. Speak to my mother. Tell her, I don't know, something nice.
The U.S. government is holding upwards of 700 prisoners in Guantanamo.
Since when did we start locking people up without a trial in this country?
That's a lot of case files.
The prosecution won't show us the evidence they have against you.
It's all redacted.
You got a problem? Take it up with the government.
All my time here, I've been told you are guilty. Not for something that I have done, but because of suspicions and associations. I am innocent.
He has been interrogated. He has been held against his will for 6 years without a single charge being laid against him.
Doesn't it bother you at all working for someone like this?
I'm not just defending him. I'm defending the rule of law.
You haven't seen what I've seen.
Where I'm from, in Mauritania, we know not to trust the police. But never did I believe that the United States of America would use fear and terror to control me.
A couple of sleepless nights, that's all. I've never been part of a conspiracy, but I'm starting to think this is what it must feel like to be on the outside of it.
You're overthinking this. Either wear the jersey or get off the field.
You need to tell me what happened to you. I can't defend you. Do you understand that?
You asked me to set fire to this place, but I'm still standing.
Maybe he's guilty.
Maybe he is. We're doing our job.
I'm not welcome home. That's not a part of my job.
If I'm wrong, when it comes to my reckoning, I'm the one that'll have to answer for it.
What makes you think you're any better than the rest of us?
I don't think I'm better than anybody else. That is the point.
For 8 years, I have been dreaming of being in a courtroom. Now that I'm here, I'm scared to death.
You know, I think I figured out why they built Guantanamo down there. My client, he's not a suspect. He's a witness.
Mr. Slahi, would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me?